by Professor Cowper's to deliver a tribute to George, I must admit that I had some mixed feelings. Because it's always sad to say, in a way, goodbye to a friend and a colleague. But then I realized that what an honor it is to pay tribute to a wonderful man who made so many contributions and had so many accomplishments for the Alameda Accounting Department and for the university. So I've known George for about 40 years, a little bit less than the time that I've been married to my wife, so I know a lot about George. First, let me begin with a few of the formalities of George's achievements. George graduated LMU in 1963, 54 years ago. Then earned a master's degree in accounting from Cal State Los Angeles. He worked in industry as a treasurer, CFO, controller, and he was a staff accountant at a CPA firm. Then he came back to LMU in 1977 to teach 14 years after he graduated. He was a practicing CPA and he was a certified fraud examiner. Let me sprinkle a few facts to explain what a CFE is and how it impacted George, because he was modest and didn't say much about this. George earned his certification while he was in his 60s. That's amazing. How many people actively at this age take on a tough challenge to earn a professional certification? Not many, I believe. This is a 10-hour exam. It has 500 questions. He studied on his own, and he passed it during his sabbatical. George basically walked the walk and talked the talk. He had high expectations for students, but he also set high expectations for himself. He was a role model for his students, as Lynn mentioned, showing that continuous education and learning are expected. These are the hallmark of a professional. There are only 30,000 CFEs, Certified Fraud Examiners, in the world. So he was part of an elite group. And he was in good company as a CFE. Some of you may remember Cynthia Cooper, who spoke at LMU about 10 years ago. She discovered fraud at WorldCom, and she was also a CFE. Also, Harry Markopoulos was a CFE. He tried to alert the Securities and Exchange Commission about Bernie Madoff and the $18 million fraud. Not to do this, and unfortunately. Now, just what did George do with his CFE certification? Well, he did more than just hang his certificate on the wall. He created a successful fraud examination course that he offered almost every spring semester to both graduate and undergraduate students. So he was a man of action. What else did George do that made him so memorable to his students? Well, as Lynn mentioned, he taught advanced accounting, which was probably our boot camp at Loyola. Not everyone made it through the first try. Students feared the course, but they loved it. If a student passed this course, they had proven themselves. And George was a tough drill sergeant. Professor DeSaro developed his grading standards, I believe, when he first began teaching at LMU in 1977, and his standards were pretty much absolute throughout his career. There wasn't a middle ground for George. Although his standards were high, the students respected and they loved him because they knew he had their best interests at heart. Some students even thought accounting 4110 was more difficult than the financial accounting and reporting section of the CPA exam. Who knows? What made George DeSaro such a memorable professor? Well, once he told me he had a formula, although he wouldn't share it with me. But anyway, over the years, I think I found the elixir of what George was doing. Well, the first element, three elements in this, George had the respect of students. Students knew that he was a competent professor and he had an excellent knowledge of financial accounting standards. Not many professors have a student's respect, but they don't move on to the next level to get that memorable status. The second element of his, of this potion, was that he had their love. And that was because students knew that he had their best interests at heart, and Lynn mentioned this earlier. Now, the third element of the elixir was a little bit of fear that was thrown into the mix. Some people say a little bit of fear is good. Well, students were in awe of George. Okay? His students truly wanted to please him, so they did their best as a result of all these elements going on. And so I learned, too, along the way, what he was doing, which helped me. So how did the students demonstrate their thanks to him? Well, on 9 occasions, the seniors awarded him Accounting Professor of the Year. And in his 39th year of teaching, which was his last year in spring 2016, he received the honor of Accounting Professor of the Year again. What a tribute. He also received the MBA Faculty Member of the Year when he was teaching at that level. So his students and the alumni are truly going to miss this wonderful man. What else did he do? Well, he was the faculty moderator of the Accounting Society for many years. George was a fatherly figure to the officers of this group. He met with them often to provide guidance and to see that they were living up to the requirements of an LMU Accounting Society officer. And Professor DeSaro wasn't afraid to tell an officer if expectations were not being met. The officers dearly loved him. He was also a member of the Faculty Housing Program Committee, and he was on the original committee that provided help to new faculty in purchasing a home. This was a very successful committee. It helped attract outstanding young faculty to LMU. This was truly a hallmark committee. It changed the type of people that we had come into Loyola to teach. He was also instrumental in selecting and presenting the Accounting Alumnus of the Year, which is presented annually at this banquet. One year, Professor DeSaro was also a recipient of this award. How fitting. He also made presentations of this award each year. We are going to miss his presentation very much this year. There's so many committees that I just can't go on mentioning them, but suffice it to say, he did a wonderful job. Again, what else did he do during his time at LMU? Well, he was the spirit of our department. Although he was never chair of the department, he was our leader, and he was a sage to us. We would frequently inquire of one another in the hallways when we were discussing any type of departmental issue. What does George think? When George spoke at a department meeting, we gave him our undivided attention. He was very important to us. Also, George could be trusted. If you told him anything in confidence, you knew that he would never divulge this to anyone else. As Shakespeare said, I shall not look upon his life again. Finally, for those of you who remember Elvis Presley, there is a famous saying relating to Elvis, and that was, Elvis has left the building. Well, the opposite applies to Professor DeSaro. He would be on campus Monday through Friday, and he would go to his off-campus office, but he'd come right back. And also, as Lynn mentioned, he had Sunday, or as the dean mentioned, he had Sunday hours. Not many professors do this. So the fact is, Professor DeSaro never really left the building. And I think he will remain in the Hilton building in spirit for many, many years to come. And I'd also like to thank Marty, who's in the audience, Marty DeSaro, George's wonderful wife, and his son, Chris, for sharing George with LMU and the accounting department for so many years, because he made such a lasting memorial difference to all of us. Thank you very much.